I just wanted to ask you, Roy, about how you felt about your side's defensive stability lately, taking out the Wolves game. But your defence has, since the two games against Liverpool and Villa, you've tightened things up considerably, haven't you?
Yeah, the Villa game was a bad one, I thought, in every respect. But it was a clear blip, as was the game previous to that, where we ran across a Liverpool that took all their chances and scored great goals. But after that, I think we're back pretty much to where we are. We lost 1-0 at Wolves, but it wasn't because we defended particularly badly. In fact, we didn't concede that many goal chances to them, but we conceded the one that lost us the game, and we weren't able to get one ourselves. But that was a very different team to the team that played tonight. We were able to make a lot of changes and give other people a chance to play. But tonight it was back to the team that had played against Leicester and Sheffield United, and it's brought us, if you like, a third game in a row in the league that we can be proud of.
I was thinking of James Tompkins, really. He had a very good game tonight, and he's only really had four or five games since he came back from his injury, but he's made a big difference, it would seem.
Well, he's an excellent player. I mean, James Tompkins is one that we've always thought is a top class centre-back. We've been delighted to work with him these last three seasons and into this fourth one, and we've missed him. He's had a really bad period with injuries, a really unfortunate period with injuries, but that seems to have passed now, and he's, with every game, he gets stronger, fitter, better, and there's no doubt that he gives us a quality centre-back in there, but he's not the only one. The Czech's done exceptionally well with him, but on top of that, there's Scott Dan and Gary Cahill, who's fit again now. So I must say, it's an area of the field where we consider ourselves quite blessed, and we're going to need it, of course, because if you want to keep clean sheets, you need a good goalkeeper and centre-backs, because you can't stop the ball coming into your penalty area. And however hard you try and stop crosses, you do get some coming in, even if only from corners and wide free kicks.
Thanks very much, Roy.
Bye, Tony.